Hi guys, how are they? Today is your first time of visiting our channel. Please subscribe. This is Naja Pride Crazy Tips. Here we'll do more on how to create mobile app, how to make money online, and also some other stuff that help. So today I'm going to be teaching you guys the alternative means of creating app without using AppYet 24. Many people have been asking me questions on alternative AppYet 24 alternative. So that's what we're going to be talking about today, okay? So but before we proceed, I would just like to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Just make sure you like this video. Even if you don't like what we're doing here, just give me that likes, okay? And also subscribe to this channel. And today we are going to talk on how to create a mobile app and the best alternative means of creating free app like all this AppYet 24 is by the use of AppYet. I'm going to teach you how you can create app using AppYet. Okay, it's very super simple, very easy, just like AppYet 24. The only thing that is needed there is just knowledge on how to follow it up, and also you need to plan your app before you start creating it. Okay, but here I'm going to just give you tutorials on how you can go about it and create mobile app, and also integrate your mobile your AdMob ADS and also make money with it. Okay, so we will move. I'm going to. Now, if you have issues or difficulties with your AdMob account, like if you're having an ADS limit, just the video that is showing on your screen right now, click on it and then watch on how you can tackle that particular issue. So then now we go. We just need to go to our browser and we're going to enter AppYet. AppYet. Then this is their website. Just click on it and then you will get to this place. Here you will need to sign up. If you don't have account already with them, you can just sign up here, okay? And if you have an account with them already, you can just put down your Gmail and your password, and then it will log you in. So I will continue with my previous stuff. Now here we go. So what are we going to do now? You can see all these are the applications that I've created so far. So but that is not what we are here for. I'm going to teach you guys how you can create another one. What you first of all need to do is just to hit on this create app here. Then it's going to take you to this particular place here. Now you're going to put your application name. Okay, let's just say that this particular stuff, just name it let's say tutorial. And when we come to the package name, you don't need to put anything here. They are going to be the one to come up with the package name, so just leave it and then come to this place. They say here you're going to select the particular template to use, but here I prefer you use blank template so you can create what you have in your mind. Okay, so looking at this place, you will notice something like, if you look at this UI here, you see how it is. So you see that you like it. If you like it this way, you can just leave it this way and click on create app. But if you don't like it, you change this home tab to menu drawer. If you check it now, you notice that something is different. You can see it. This is how it's going to look like. You can see this is how it's going to look like. So what are we going to do now? If you like it this way, we can just click on create app. Okay, and here we are going to set some other things like our app icon. We're going to set the app icon. Let's change the app icon and select the file. Click on file, and it's going to take you to this place. And here we're going to select icon that we're going to use. Okay, let's use this icon. And here you're going to select the content rating. This is a kind of everyone. If you want everyone to rate this app, like people that it can be recommended to, you can just use everyone. If you tick this low maturity, it means below, you know what I mean, and below age, people that are still under age, where medium and high maturity, you know what I mean. So what are we going to do now? We're going to select everyone because we're building the app for everyone. Okay, now what are we going to do now? We need to hit on this save changes. Now you can see this, everything have changed. The icon is showing here, and that's it. Now we need to go to modules. Is just a kind of the UI, how you want it, or the content of the app, what's going to be in the app, you understand. So what are we going to do? We're going to, you know, select new modules. So we are, let me just use YouTube. Just click on YouTube, and here it's going to show you this. Then the menu, you just say Niger Pride Crazy Tips. Okay, now here you're going to say build feed by a YouTube user ID, YouTube channel ID, YouTube playlist ID. So here we're going to choose YouTube channel ID. Okay, we're going to paste the URL of our channel. Hope you know how you can get your channel ID. So to get channel ID, you just need to go straight to your YouTube, and once you get to YouTube, you go to YouTube Studio, and once you get to YouTube Studio, we are just looking for your ID. Allow it to load. Then you go to customization. That is where you're going to see. Then you click on customization. Then you go to basic information. Scroll down. Here you're going to see your channel URL. That is the stuff we are talking about. So yeah, from this point now, this is your, let me show you, from this point to this point is your channel ID. Just from here now to this place is your channel ID. So you just need to copy only this. Just need to copy from here. This is it. You see? So what do? We copy from there. Just copy it and then go back to AppYet and now paste it here. You now save. Now this is it. So if you need to set or some other things here, you can just set it here, but let's just update it and leave it like that. So you can see that the feed has been added. So what are we going to do? If you really need to add another feed, you can still add it. Okay, so but now let's go back to modules.
If you want to add another modules, you can still add them. You can add as many as you like. Okay, now let's build our app. You can go to theme, and if you like, you can change the theme predefined dark and light mode theme. Okay, so the next thing is to monetize the app, and this is the main point. You can see this, the only way you can make money that is your app is by monetizing the app. Okay, so here you just need to select the particular ad provider you really need to use. If you want to use Google AdMob, you can use it. If you like to use Facebook Audience Network, you can use it. But here we are selecting AdMob. So what are we going to do? We need to put we're going to use the demo ad unit. Let's just collect this banner. Copy banner. And then go to the section and paste the banner here. Though it requested for AdMob app ID, we're going to copy this one here and paste for them there. Okay, but this is not the correct. If you are using your real ad units, you need to use your AdMob app ID and paste it here. Okay, then if you want to show interstitial ads, just turn this place on, and it will give you the option for interstitial ID unit. Now let's go and copy the interstitial and paste it there. Then we'll save it. It says invalid AdMob app ID. What is this? We copied the wrong something. It's not complete. So this is where we're supposed to copy it from. This is the main problem that many of us face at times. You just copy from here and to this place, and you don't know that this CA is minus APP minus PUB is also part of it. You just copy other numbers and then put it there. It's not going to show, just like what happened now. So we just paste it here, and then it will save automatically. You can see it has been successfully saved. Now we are going to build our app. Click on build here. It's going to show you here. So what are we going to do? It has been successfully built. You can see it here. Okay, what are we going to do? We are going to click on download APK. If you want to publish on Play Store, you can use this particular one. This is the one you download for uploading it to Play Store. Then this one is just for testing it here. Okay, now it has been downloaded. Open the app to see what it has for us, and then I install it. They said blocked by Play Protect. Today's trending news. Okay, yeah, this app, I'm the one that developed it, so and I know it's not going to harm my phone, so I install anyway. Now we need to open the app so we can check what we've done so far to see if it is working correctly. Alright, okay, you can see it here. This is the video from that channel. Somebody asked me this question once upon a time, that if he uploaded or embed his YouTube video on inside this app, the whole channel will just open. So you can use this app here to create this kind of a thing, because this one is going to segment those videos. You can see it. You can see it. All these are the videos in Niger Practice Tip. Okay, so here all these are the stuffs. To remove all these particular, all these ones, all these things, you can just go to your general and remove the ones that you don't want to see. Okay, so this one is the Niger Pride stuff. You can see it. The video is segmented. You can see this, the
This is the ad unit we embedded here. You can see it here. You see it? The test ad that we embedded the other time. Okay. That is it. Thank you for watching today's tutorial. And may God bless you as you follow and like our channel. Thank you.